Hello, my name is Julie Mipuri, and I'm the senior author for this manuscript. I'm a physician scientist specialized in neonatology at UT Southwestern Medical Center. My laboratory is focused on understanding neonatal intestinal colonization and the interaction with the developing intestinal immune response. Today, I'd like to introduce you to our manuscript entitled Maternal High-Fat Diet Results in Microbiota-Dependent Expansion of ILC3 Cells in Mice Offspring, published in JCI Insight. I would first like to acknowledge the contributions of Sarah Thomas Babu and Xinying Niu, the first and second authors, without whom this work would not have been possible. As a physician, I take care of preterm infants that can develop a devastating disease called necrotizing enterocolitis, or NEC. NEC affects about 2 million preterm infants worldwide and has a very high mortality, with 30% of these infants dying. And of the survivors, half of them develop significant morbidity, including short bowel syndrome and long-term deficits in cognition and development. NEC has been associated with an immature immune response and abnormal bacterial colonization of the intestine. Maternal obesity is an antecedent for the development of NEC. Of note, maternal obesity and overweight now accounts for over 50% of women of childbearing age in the United States. We chose to look at how maternal high-fat diet affects offspring due to the increase in obesity worldwide and transition to a diet that is much higher in fat. We asked the questions, does maternal high-fat diet alter the neonatal microbiome and immune responses? Does it affect the newborn's susceptibility to a model of NEC? This paper examines how maternal high-fat diet can alter the neonatal microbiome and intestinal immune response, increasing susceptibility to a model of NEC. We hypothesized that this exposure to maternal high-fat diet would alter the offspring's microflora and put offspring at risk for NEC. We utilize a mouse model where we expose breeding mice to a high-fat diet. The diet we chose to use is 60% fat, primarily saturated fat. Female mice are placed on a high-fat diet beginning at 3 weeks of age. They are mated with male mice that have previously been on a regular diet at 8 weeks. This was done to solely test the effect of exposure of high-fat diet in the mother. Offspring from the high-fat diet breeding pair are cross-fostered shortly after birth to either a high-fat diet mother or regular diet mother, where they nurse for 3 weeks. For this paper, we designate the birth mother first and the nursing mother second. So for example, if an offspring is born to a high-fat diet mother and cross-fostered to a regular diet mother, they are designated as high-fat diet / regular diet offspring. We ensure that mothers do not develop insulin resistance by determining 1 hour fasting glucose levels every other week in breeding mothers, since insulin resistance can be a confounding factor. Of note, our offspring from either regular diet or high-fat diet mothers are of similar weights at birth, so there is no intrauterine growth failure. We first examined offspring at 1, 2, and 3 weeks of age by quantitative real-time PCR and next-generation sequencing to determine their bacterial colonization in the intestine, or microbiota. We compare them to regular diet control offspring. One of the most striking findings, illustrated in Figure 1A and B, is the difference in the offspring microbiota as early as 1 week of life. These changes are illustrated in this heat map, where red represents increased relative abundance of the bacteria. The heat map shows 3 representative 1-week-old high-fat diet offspring above and 3 representative regular diet offspring below. We found that high-fat diet offspring had an expansion of members of the Firmicutes phylum, which was very different from regular diet offspring at the same age that have an expansion of proteobacteria. These changes are also represented in the pie charts. Panel B shows mice at 1 week of age, and panel C shows mice at 3 weeks of age. The increase in Firmicutes persisted to 3 weeks of age in the high-fat diet offspring, and notably persisted even when they were cross-fostered at birth to regular diet mothers. We then looked at the inflammatory profile in the intestine of these similar-aged mice. we found that IL-17, the cytokine, was significantly increased in the high-fat diet offspring as early as 1 week of age and remained persistently elevated at 3 weeks. We initially hypothesized that Th17 cells would therefore be expanded since they produce IL-17, and since Firmicutes, particularly the segmented filamentous bacteria, have been shown to expand Th17 cells in the intestine. However, we found that Th17 cells were barely represented, and instead we found that the cells increased in the high-fat diet offspring were ROR gamma T positive, CD127 positive, CD117 positive, CD3 negative, NKp46 positive, and CD4 negative. This was consistent with type 3 innate lymphoid cells. Neonatal mice and human infants do not have a mature adaptive immune response, and it makes sense that these innate cells are playing an important role. We further test that these are truly ILC3 cells by examining RAG-deficient mice, which do not have mature T and B cells. And indeed, we found a similar phenotype as we describe in our manuscript. Further, we utilized neocolonization experiments in microbiologically sterile mice and demonstrate that the ILC3 expansion is indeed microbiota dependent. For clinical relevance, we wanted to determine if these neonatal mice are susceptible to early intestinal inflammation, akin to necrotizing enterocolitis. We utilized a well-established model for NEC, known as the LPS-PAF model. In this model, we exposed neonatal mice at 12 to 14 days of life with an intraperitoneal injection of lipopolysaccharide, LPS, and platelet activation factor, PAF, for 2 hours. The small intestine is examined by histology and scored for epithelial and crypt integrity, infiltration of inflammatory cells to the mucosa, submucosa, and the muscle layers. These findings are illustrated in Figure 4. Figure 4a shows representative histological sections in the regular diet and high-fat diet offspring. We found after exposure to LPS-PAF, the high-fat diet offspring have significantly higher injury scores with more destruction of the crypts and infiltration of inflammatory cells. Of note, when we then pre-treated high-fat diet offspring beginning at 5 days of life with an IL-17 blocking antibody, these mice were then rescued from this high-fat diet phenotype with much lower histological injury scores. We performed similar experiments in RAG-deficient mice on high-fat diet and found similar results. Combined, these data support the role of IL-17 producing ILC type 3 cells in increasing susceptibility to NEC in maternal high-fat diet offspring. In essence, we have shown that exposure to a high-fat diet during pregnancy alters the microbiota composition in offspring and increases their susceptibility to a gut inflammatory challenge. We report for the first time that offspring of mothers on high-fat diet have a unique microbiota with an expansion of Firmicutes. Mechanistically, these offspring have an increase in IL-17 that is due to an expansion of ILC3 cells. Interestingly, the microbiota of offspring of high-fat diet exposed mothers alone is sufficient to cause an expansion of ILC3 cells. Importantly, the offspring of high-fat diet exposed mothers have an IL-17 dependent increased susceptibility to intestinal inflammation. Taken together, these results reveal that a maternal high-fat diet results in a microbiota-dependent expansion of ILC3 and increased susceptibility to intestinal injury in offspring mediated by IL-17. This work, while outlined in mice, carries significant implications for future directions. It suggests novel therapeutic approaches for the treatment of NEC and preterm infants, either via modulation of the microbiota, ILC3 expansion, or IL-17 production. Our current projects focus on further dissecting these mechanisms. Thank you for listening. We hope you enjoy reading the manuscript.